We all do it. We make New Year's resolutions, but every year we fail to stick with them. Joining us today to set the perfect resolution, and it does exist, is Dr. Josh Klepo. And thank you so much for being with us. He has this expert opinion, and that was the first question I just asked you, is it possible to have a perfect New Year's resolution?
It's possible to set a perfect New Year's resolution.
Okay.
It is possible to stick with it. It is not 100% guaranteed, mm-hmm. but I can tell you that so many people set them wrong and they start off basically failing before they ever start. So that's kind of what I want to talk about, is how do you set it in a way that sets you up for success.
Okay, so what is the first step? Is it just deciding what you want to change about your life or what you want to accomplish in the year? What's the first step?
That, you obviously have to think about that, mm-hmm. but you have to take that idea of what you want to change about your life and make it super specific. So people will say, like, I want to get healthy. I want to lose weight. I want to improve my relationships. I want to make more money.
Yeah, a lot of big grand plans.
That doesn't tell you anything.
Okay.
I want to go to the gym 3 days a week at 6:30 in the morning for 45 minutes. Super specific. I want to save $50 every month through automatic deduction. The more specific, the more likely you are to succeed. And a lot of people don't do that.
So the details matter.
Absolutely, absolutely. Second thing, everybody says, I want to do all these things. Mm-hmm. And what I challenge people to do is do a gut check. Do you really want to do these things? Do you really want to lose weight? Do you really want, because a lot of times we have four or five things that we need to change, mm-hmm. and we get caught up in the New Year's resolution stuff, and we go for things that really, we don't really want to do. It's okay to not want to make that change.
So we have to be detail oriented. We have to be passionate about what we want to do. What else do we have to do?
Make it reachable. You hear people shoot for the stars. I'm going to run a marathon. I'm going to lose 100 pounds. I would much rather have you say, I'm going to lose 10 pounds, lose it, and then lose another 10 pounds. Or I'm going to run a 5K and then run that 5K and then go to the 10K. This idea that you have to reach for the stars sets you up for failure. Success breeds success. You're more likely to succeed if you have something that's reachable.
All right, so our resolution can change throughout the year as long as we stay focused, we stay passionate, and we stay committed. Thank you for sharing your expertise with us. We'll see you back here next week with how we can maintain those goals. Looking forward.